Welcome to our channel Engineer's Choice Tutor. In today's lecture, we see the use of instance of operator. Okay, so instance of is an operator in Java. We can use instance of to check whether the given object is of particular type or not. And we know the type at the beginning. Okay, suppose I have one object. Okay, I have to check that this object is student type or not. So how I write? Okay, how I know that this object is of student type or not? By the help of the instance of operator. Okay, so how to use instance of operator syntax? What is the syntax that we have to see now? So the instance of operator verifies whether its first operand is an instance of its second or not. Okay, the syntax is op1, that is operand 1, instance of operand 2. Okay, so op1 must be the name of an object, okay, and op2 must be the name of a class, interface or array type. Is it clear? And now see the example. Suppose I have created one thread object. So thread t is equal to new thread. Okay, so system.out.println t instance of runnable, what it will give? It will give true. Why it will give true? Because t is what type? Thread type. You know na, thread is instance of runnable only, because thread implements the runnable interface. Okay na? So thread is also the runnable type. That's why it returns what? True. And the second line, see, system.out.println t instance of object. So t is thread type. Okay, t is what? Thread type object. So t is the instance of object or not? True. Okay, it also returns true. Why? Because in Java, na, the object class is the parent class of all the classes in Java, okay, by default. So, the supermost class, the parent class of all the Java classes is objects. That